Jay-Z in VR. Yes, you heard it right. Someone by the name of Dave managed to get Jay-Z working in virtual reality. It was complicated to get it set up, and I had to pay for some software. But I fired up my Oculus Quest 2 and dived in to see if it was any good. Oh, baby. All right, well, we're already starving to death. Oh, God, I'm going to die to the environment in VR. Let's go over there, I think. Whoa, man, this is weird. See my buddy. So what does this feel like in VR? I have obviously played VR before, and straight away you can tell that this game is not designed for VR. Not yet, anyway. Let's look at this tree. Oh, look at that texture. I feel like I could kiss this tree, and I'm not going to do that. Yeah, let's keep going. Now, you're probably wondering about controls. I'm using mouse and keyboard, so it's the same as you normally would be doing, but my God, is it different. Apparently, my whole body moves when I turn my head left and right as well. You can use a controller, which might be easier, but I don't have one, so we're just using mouse and keyboard. How the hell am I going to pick this up? Ah! Come on. You can do it. You can do it. Ah! I got it. Everything looks so much bigger and wider. Like it's a bit stretched. Oh man, this is so weird. I can feel like I can touch that. Take that light bulb out and replace it with a new one. Now, to give you a VR experience in 2D is very difficult. And it's a very difficult thing to explain if you've never experienced it yourself. But it's like you're here. That's the worst explanation of VR ever. Now, there's a few bugs that I've come across already. And one was that when I looked up, it went down. And when I looked down, it went up. So I had to invert the controls, which means that it works in VR. Like, your head moves up and down. But when you try and move your mouse up, it goes down. And when I'm pulling down, it goes up. Yeah, the controls are very, very weird. Our first zombie is over there. I don't know how this is going to go. Come on there, Mr. Zombie. Oh, this is weird. Oh, God. Block Gecko, where's he gone? Ah. Oh, my. This is so difficult. I did it. Bit by bit, I'm getting used to the controls. It's very difficult, though. How could I describe this VR experience? It's like you can't afford a skateboard, so you get some plywood and you put some wheels on it and you cut it and sellotape the wheels on and everything. And then you've got yourself a budget skateboard. That is what this feels like. How else can I explain this mode? It's like you're trying to make a cake and you don't have any eggs, so you have to improvise and like add something else in replace of eggs. Doesn't quite taste the same, but it's a cake nonetheless. Actually, the textures look better in some cases than other VR games that I've tried. I remember playing The Forest in VR and the grass just looked really weird. It didn't look good. But this looks good, and I think it looks good because it's using your monitor's view, so there's more pixels in there. This doesn't work like normal VR. That leaf at the top is right in my face. I felt like blowing the leaf. You see, Gecko's never died to the environment, even in VR, man. Even with these challenging controls that don't fucking make any sense. Up, down, when you look up in VR, it goes up. But when you use your mouse, it goes down when you look up. And then you're trying to realign the camera and try to work out geometric physics in your head to see if it actually works. I wonder if I can lock the zombies in here. Oh! I don't know what is going on right now. The FPS that I'm getting is the same I would get normally while being in game. Now, this map is called Melkart. I've not actually tried this on normal mode. As in, you know, non-VR?
Yeah!
I feel much more immersed when I'm fighting zombies. We're picking up some speed here. This is where you might start to feel sick. I've never been more impressed by a DayZ sign before. I feel like I could touch that and feel the metal. But when I try, my hand just hits my monitor. As I said in the intro, the program, the Vorpex, isn't free. I had to pay £32 for it. The way it was worded, like the instruction thing, it was like, this is just one option. There may be others that might be free, but it's basically like some kind of driver that makes games run in VR. Oh, this is going to be scary now in the nighttime. I don't want it to get dark. It's so zoomed in. It's like having a 30 degree field of view. That's what it feels like. So when you're navigating in tight corners and houses, it's really difficult. I think DayZ has some good potential to be an actual VR title. I don't know if the Infusion Engine is capable of VR and whether DayZ would be easy to port to VR. And this game isn't even full VR, but the experience is decent enough to give you an insight into what a full DayZ experience in VR would be like. Everything looks bigger in VR. I wonder if there's some kind of military up ahead. Could it be that we're going to get an actual gun and be able to shoot it? Yes, this looks just as stupid as you'd imagine in VR. Oh, shit. Oh, God, this is not good. Keep blocking, Gecko. You overcome this. My first ever shot in VR. I'm aiming with my head. Oh, this is hard. There we go. Woo! Damn, that looked good. Oh, this is so hard. Oh, let's go up on a crane. Let's climb that crane, see what that's like. Oh, this is actually really cool. Oh no. How do I get off? Yeah. I'm alive. I guess you can't go off on that one. Let's see how high this one is. Whoa. I feel like I could survive if I jumped off this. Could I make that jump down there? Parkour it from there to there and then onto there. So, is it any good? It's decent. But DayZ really isn't designed for VR. And you can quite easily see that when you're playing it. But it was still fun and showed the possibilities of what could be achieved in the future. Now, I did have to purchase some software for £32 for what was for me a novelty one-off experience. But I will leave details in the description if you want to give it a try for yourself. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye now.